Dr. Jason Zahner's here with HBOT USA. So our next question is, well, how does hyperbaric oxygen actually work? And so in order to really understand the mechanism that hyperbaric works by, I want to explain normal oxygenation, normal circulation, because you have to understand that first to know why hyperbaric is such a powerful tool. So on my finger is a pulse oximeter. And probably most people have either seen this, or if you've been in the hospital or have had a physical, they put something like this on your finger. And what this is measuring is literally the oxygen attached to red blood cells in your body. And so right now, my pulse ox, as we call it, is 97%. So what that means is 97% of my red blood cells are to capacity with their ability to carry oxygen. Or to simplify that, you could say, if I had 100 red blood cells, 97 of them were carrying oxygen. It's not exactly how it is, but it's kind of an easy way to understand it. Now, what that really means is that if I had a green tank of medical oxygen and a mask, and I wore that mask and I breathed 100% oxygen, I could very easily go from 97% saturated to 100% saturated. And if I did that, obviously, I could make up about 3% more oxygen by doing that. But no matter how long I breathe on that mask of that oxygen, I could never go beyond 100% saturation, because 100% is 100%. So the reason that hyperbaric is so powerful is that because of two laws, mainly Boyle's law and Henry's law, Boyle's law says that as you take a gas, whatever gas that is, and you put pressure on it, you can make that gas take up less space. And then Henry's law, which basically says, as you pressurize that gas and it takes up less space, you can dissolve a higher percentage of that gas into a liquid. The easiest example is a can of seltzer. A can of seltzer was using water, and it's using carbon dioxide, not oxygen, but same idea. If you could pressurize a gas, carbon dioxide, you could fit a lot of gas in a little can. And by doing that, you're absorbing, you're dissolving that gas into the water, making that water carbonated. Hyperbaric is basically the same idea, except now we're taking air or oxygen, and we're compressing the amount of air or oxygen into a hyperbaric chamber. And then if we have somebody inside that pressurized environment, we're able to increase the absorption and the dissolving of that oxygen into the person's liquids. And for us, what that really means is we're dissolving oxygen into the plasma of our blood and directly into our tissue. So normally we're relying on red blood cells to carry oxygen throughout our entire body. And that's the only way we have to oxygenate every cell inside of our body. When you're in a hyperbaric environment, because of pressure, you're literally dissolving oxygen into the plasma of the blood. And the plasma can handle many hundreds of times more oxygen than the red blood cells can alone. And so depending on how much pressure you use and depending on how much oxygen you're exposing the person to determines how much more oxygen that person can tolerate and absorb and then use for all the things that oxygen does in our cells: produce energy, help us detoxify, reduce inflammation, heal, recover, all those things. So that's basically the premise behind how hyperbaric oxygen actually works.